This is BBC News with me, Ben Brown. Our headlines at 5 o'clock. The Transport Secretary accuses union leaders of punishing millions of innocent people by pressing ahead with rail strikes this week.
It just seems the union is determined to go out on strike, the RMT, come what may. And I think it's a very sad situation. I call on them to reconsider.
We want a settlement to this dispute, but we're facing a crisis for our members. We're faced with thousands of job cuts, despite what Grant Shapps says. There's been no guarantee that these redundancies won't be compulsory.
As the conflict in Ukraine continues, the new head of the British Army tells his troops they should be prepared to fight in Europe once again. Dozens of people have died and millions of others are stranded after floods in Bangladesh and India. Communities in Finsbury Park gather to mark 5 years since the terror attack there, in which a van was driven into worshippers outside a mosque. And it's not long to go until voting closes in the final round of the parliamentary elections in France, with President Emmanuel Macron facing an alliance of left-wing parties. A picture of the Duke of Cambridge with his children has been released to celebrate Father's Day. Hello, good afternoon. Let's start with some breaking news. The International Swimming Federation has voted to restrict the participation of transgender athletes in elite women's events. Former world champion swimmer Karen Pickering, MBE, has tweeted on the transgender ruling by that federation, FINA, saying, "I was at the FINA Congress for the presentation, discussion and vote, and I can vouch for the care and empathy displayed for any athletes who won't now be able to compete in the category their gender ID may align to." So let's just tell you a little bit more about that. This is swimming's world governing body, FINA, which has voted to restrict the participation of transgender athletes in elite women's competitions and to create, they say, a working group to establish an open category for them in some events as part of a new policy. This decision has been made at the Swimming World Governing Body's Extraordinary General Congress on the sidelines of the World Championships in Budapest. It will require transgender competitors to have completed their transition by the age of 12 in order to be able to compete in women's competitions. So that is just in from swimming's world governing body, FINA, and we'll of course bring you reaction to that as soon as we get it, and some more details as well. Now, other news, and the Transport Secretary has said it's not for the government to intervene to try to prevent 3 days of strikes on the railways this week. Grant Shapps dismissed calls from the RMT union to get involved in the dispute as a stunt, saying it's for the employers and the unions to reach an agreement. Mr. Shapps says the strikes would be an act of self-harm. The Labour leader, Keir Starmer, says the government wants the strikes to go ahead to sow division in society. Here's our political correspondent, Damien Grammaticus.